Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today I just want to say thank you so much for all the 7 people who have subscribed to my channel. It really means a lot and thank you for all the views I've gotten on my first video. I've gotten like 132 views on my first video in 2 weeks and I really think that's amazing. I really appreciate it and I really hope you enjoy my content about living an intentional life. And all the subjects I'll be diving into that is underneath that subject in my life. So on this channel, I'm gonna be talking about what an intentional life looks like to me. But today, I'm gonna be talking about how I get through a period in my life where I feel burned out.
I want to start with reading a quote.
Talking about what a burnout is. And it's fun. WebMD, and I'm gonna link the details of the article down below, and of course I'm gonna leave a link to the article so you create it yourself. It's made by Dan Burnout from WebMD. Burnout is a form of exhaustion caused by constantly feeling swamped. It's a result of excessive and prolonged emotional, physical, and mental stress. Burnout keeps you from being productive. It reduces your energy, making you feel hopeless, cynical, and resentful. The effects of burnout can hurt your home, work, and social life. Long-time burnout can make you more vulnerable to colds and flus. And I also know that you can get flu-like symptoms or symptoms of a cold if you're really burned out. But it makes sense that if you're burned out that your immune system is more vulnerable to colds and flus because your immune system is
compromised.
And then I want to talk about how long a burnout has lasted for me. Actually, I sadly deal a lot with this. And normally, for me, it's a day or a couple of days or 1 to 2 weeks that I feel burned out. But it could also be a couple of months if I really have pressured myself a lot for far too long. And then I want to talk about what a period of my life looks like where I'm burned out. It's a period of my life where the smallest everyday tasks can seem impossible to overcome because I'm mentally and physically exhausted. I have no energy and therefore I have to force myself to do everything that needs to be done. It's a period in my life where my body is telling me that I need to take a break and take it slow and relax. And if I don't listen to my body, it will force me to stop. And I will become so burned out that I can't do anything anymore for a period. It might also be a day where I have too many plans for the day, for things I want to get done. And then all of a sudden, I just lose all my energy before I even get started really with the day. And what makes me burn out? It is when I have forced myself to do more than I can handle for a long period of time, where I might not have taken enough breaks. When something hard has happened in my life, for example, sadly a couple of weeks ago, I lost my hamster. But what makes it really hard right now is that my other hamster, he has gotten what I think is cancer. So we are going to the vet later today, and by today I mean the 6th December, and so that's really hard because it has happened a couple of weeks within each other, and he's a really old man and I don't think he's coming back. I think it's cancer that he's going to be put to sleep, because I've had other pets before with cancer, so I know how it looks in a hamster. So that could be an example of a really, very hard period of my life that kind of triggers a burnout. And for me, that has been really triggering lately, and I've been on the verge of a burnout for a period now, so I'm really trying to take care of myself because it's really hard right now. Having lost one pet a couple of weeks ago and probably losing one more. And we're also in the winter months right now in Denmark, and there's not as much light as there usually are when you're in spring and summer. Right now there's light outside, as you probably could see. My video is pretty bright, but that's because it's like early in the day. But when we get to like 4 o'clock, a little before, you know, we go into the evening, it is already dark around that point. So I really get depressed, you could say, in the winter months because it's so dark outside. And maybe also because it's cold, but usually I only hear it's something to do with the light when you get a winter depression, because it's darker outside. And then I want to talk about what I do to get through this period where I have burnout. I focus a lot on how I talk to myself, and I focus on not talking too harshly to myself and not being too judgmental against myself. If I talk negatively to myself, I start to think about why the negative things I'm saying to myself is not true, because usually I'm being too harsh on myself. And I try to show myself compassion and empathy, even though it is hard. An example of this could be that I was thinking I haven't done something good enough, and then I start to think that I'm not good enough. And then I could turn around by thinking something like, I have done the best I can, and that's the best I can do. We make mistakes to learn from them. So that's just an example of how I convert my thoughts in my head so they are less negative and they are more compassionate towards myself. Because when I go through a period where I'm burned out, I usually talk more harshly to myself. So it's really important that you catch yourself doing this, and that you train yourself to talk in a nicer way to yourself, in a more empathic way to yourself. Another thing that helps me in the winter months is that I have a light therapy lamp. And if you want to see me doing a video about that, about my light therapy lamp and how it helps me in the winter months, I would also love to do that. Just comment down below if you would like to see that. And I also focus on relaxing a lot. I focus on sleeping a lot more and taking a nap during the day so I have more energy. And then I really focus on only doing the things that cannot wait to another day. So kind of the, we say, urgent things. Because I don't want to do the other things when I'm burned out. I don't want to put any more pressure on myself because my body is telling me I need to relax. And I've seen a lot of YouTubers doing these reset days, and I just think it's kind of weird, because if you're really burned out, you know, you need to take a break, you don't need to do more things. So yeah, I think that's kind of weird. But anyways, I want to say thank you for watching this video, it really means a lot to me. And thank you so much again for the 7 subscribers. Thank you for the 132 views I've gotten on my first video. I'm really impressed I've got so many in such a short period of time. So thank you so much to everyone supporting me in the start of my YouTube journey. I really, really appreciate it, and I'll see you soon.